A very good morning, dear students. I hope you all are enjoying at home. You all are fine. Before PT1 examination, we have completed chapter 1 of computer application. Today we are discussing about chapter 2, that is internet and web services, in which we will cover the topics information retrieval, chat, video conferencing, e-banking, e-reservation. So many topics are there. So today we'll start this chapter, and the first topic of this chapter, that is given as per your book, it is your introduction part. By the turn of the century, information including access to the internet will be the basis for a personal, economic and political advancement. The popular name for internet is information superhighway. Whether you want to find the latest financial news, browse through library catalog, exchange information with colleagues, or join a lively political debate, internet is the tool that will take you beyond telephonic, faxes, isolated computer to a burgeoning network information frontier. The main to read this chapter is that internet, how is accessible in our routine life. Basically, internet can be used everywhere, either it is educational, either it is communication, either it is transfer of information, either it is for finding a particular document. It is a primary tool. That's why it is also known as a super highway, and it can be used for political or social advancement also. The internet supplement the traditional tools you use to gather information like email, video conferencing, and use skillfully. The internet shrinks the world and the bring information, expertise and knowledge on nearly every subject imagining straight to your computer. Internet is a tool that will help to provide each type of information, either it is related to subject, either it is related to your article, either it is related to your news, either it is related to a particular document. Lot of online products selling websites are also available on internet, like Amazon, Walmart, Lenskart, Craftvilla. So many are there that are providing services and selling or buying the products. Amazon is the American firm established in 1996. It was founded by the current CEO of company, that is Jeff Bezos, and is currently the richest person on the earth. It started a brick and mortar version selling books, and it gradually diversified and now has become online presence, has presence in India and sell groceries also. It has a replacement policy and quick delivery system. Amazon India is the one of most used Indian e-commerce player, and the Amazon sites get approximately 1.87 billion visits per month. And Walmart is headed by Sam Walton. It is the one of the richest people in the world. It started off a brick and mortar firm, but now it has online presence. And Walmart has recently bought out the Indian website that is known as Flipkart. And it was started in 1962, and it started its online presence from 2000. And it has discount schemes for different type of items. Like this, another option is there, that is Lenskart. Everybody is aware about these types of services. It is exclusively dealing with the eyewear, and it sells up to 5000 different type of eyewears, approximately from rupees 385 to rupees 30,000. And Yepme is the online store meant for men and women dresses and apparels. And so many options are there. So these are the examples. So now we are coming on the particular topic. Topic is information retrieval. The topic that we are covering, that is information retrieval. Information retrieval, the process of exploring and retrieving the information from internet is called net surfing or information retrieval. When your computer is connected to access the information which you need, by using an application, it is known as web browser. And internet and web services, which type of services provided? To retrieve the information, to find the information from internet, we need to specify a unique address that is also known as URL, that is known as Uniform Resource Locator of website, and the web page containing the information in the address bar of the web browser. Like you're searching on Google, so you'll write google.com. And information retrieval is the process of retrieving relevant information from a database which is already stored. So it is shown like this. Goel Prakashan page is given, any website it can be. When you type the URL of particular web page in the address bar of the browser and press the enter key, the browser retrieves the web page from the internet and shows the content to a user. And the process of taking the content from a web page and saving it on your personal computer, it is known as the concept of downloading. And when we are referring the process of posting the content on web page, it is known as uploading. So two processes are there, uploading and downloading. Afterward, checkpoint exercise is there. So first fill up, dash is the processing of retrieving relevant information from database. Guess the answer. The answer is information retrieval is the processing of retrieving relevant information from a database. Next is the full form of URL is dash. The answer will be, it will be Uniform Resource Locator. Again I speak, Uniform Resource Locator. Third, dash refers to the process of posting the content on a web page. When we are posting the content on a web page, it is known as uploading. When we are downloading the content, it is the process of downloading. Next topic, it is search engine. Search engine is a tool to searching the document on a web page. They are very important in our student life, researcher or a teacher. This is because you search for things properly on the internet, provided you don't know which website will go to using the search engine. So search engine is a website on the internet with a sophisticated software at the back end. And by using, we are able to find out the web page. Suppose we want to buy any product, but we don't know the company name. We will just write the company product name only in the google.com search engine. It will automatically provide different type of alternate products for the similar category item. So a search engine is a computer program that searches for the information on the web, and the most popular search engine is Google. And some other search engines are also there, like Yahoo search, Bing is also there. And Bing is the recent search engine. It is developed by Microsoft. It also does good search and on Windows 10 default browser. Edge is also the default search engine in the Bing. And the full form of Bing is not Google, a recursive long form. If you search for any term by typing into the address of bar of Edge, the search will be conducted by Bing rather than any other search engine. So there are so many search engines available, like Google, Bing, Ask, AltaVista, AOL, Lycos, Alexa. Like Google, it is also called Backrub. It is the most popular search engine. Bing, it is launched by Microsoft in 2009, and it is the latest web-based search engine. And Ask, it was launched in 1996 and originally known as Ask Jeeves. It supports for match, dictionary and conversation questions. And AltaVista, it is the product that is launched by Digital Equipment Corporation in 1995, and since 2003 it is the powered by Yahoo technology. And AOL, it is powered by Google. And Lycos, it is the top 5 internet portal and 13th largest online property according to the media metrics. And Alexa, it is the product of Amazon. So how it will work? Search engine will work by 3 steps. Step 1 is web crawling, indexing and searching. What is web crawling? Web search engine works by storing information about many web pages. These pages are retrieved by the program known as web crawler, and which follow every link on the site. And web crawler may also be called a web spider. It will collect the related links according to the search of user. Indexing will arrange in a sequential order. It is also known as web indexing. It stores data to facilitate fast and accurate information retrieval. It means whatsoever is the best match, it will keep it on the first position. And searching is a search query fetch that will fetch the result from a web search engine entered by user to meet his information requirement. Searching is the process for searching. Crawling is the process for finding all the links that are related, and indexing is to manage all the links. So how to find information on web page? Directly just enter the Yahoo search engine like yahoo.com. In address bar write the particular item whatsoever you want to search, and you will directly find out the item. Type the keyword whatsoever you want to search. It can search like web, images, videos, so many things it can search. Now how to find the people on internet? It is also possible. We can search out the people that are most famous people. Like you want to search Narendra Modi, you can easily find out. So Yahoo People Search Engine is a database that contains public information which can be used to find friends and family with whom you have lost touch. And you can search for people using their names and location or phone numbers. You can also search using email addresses. Just open the Yahoo homepage. Type the name of person whom you want to search. For example, you want to search Narendra Modi. Just type Narendra Modi and press enter key. It will search the related content. And some other websites like facebook.com is also used for same, people.com, indiabook.com, LinkedIn or any who. And the major point that is here, people is the most popular search engine. Here it is given in hint, although people is the world largest people search engine. It is one mark question for exam also. So in Facebook, there is a good chance that a person you are looking for has a profile there, and you can easily search out the person by finding the name. Now checkpoint is there. Dash is the world largest people search engine. The answer will be, it will be people. Recently we have studied, and indexing is also known as web indexing. And Alta Vista was launched by Digital Equipment Corporation in 1995. Next is, what is chat? Chat is a text-based communication that is live and in real time. For example, when you talk to someone in chat, any type text is received by other participant immediately. In contrast, other text-based communication such as email are also correspondence for the same. A chat room is a online site in which people can chat online, talk with each other. Sometimes these venues are moderated either by limited who are allowed to speak or not, by having moderation volunteer patrols. So chat refers to the process of communicating, interacting or exchanging their messages over the internet. Chat system come in a variety of styles, like it can be a 3D environment, it can be MSN, AIM, so many common send time instant messaging tools are available. Some would argue that these are not truly chat room as they are characterized by being one-to-one conversation with people like buddy list. So recent, these systems have started to incorporate the ability to chat with multiple people. Primarily it was one-to-one interaction, but we can now talk with a multiple concept in a same chat room. Chat rooms are often confused, especially by the popular medias, with discussion group or online forums. So different types of chats are available. Like first one is IM, that is also an instant messaging. And second is IRC, Internet Relay Chat. What is instant messages? As the name suggests, it is a form of real-time communication between two or more people based on typed text. It is a text type message. And the text is conveyed via computer connected over a network such as the internet. And Internet Relay Chat, IRC, is a form of instant communication over the internet, and it is mainly designed for a group communication. It is not one-to-one communication, and it is like a channel form, but also allows one-to-one communication. And the example is Talkcity, and many other chat websites are available for IRC. And the main thing, IRC was created by Jerko Aklian, Third type of chat is web-based chat. It is a real-time chat where user can chat in a particular website by using a browser, by using another option is there also, that is known as chatbot. And mailing list, it contains each person's email address and it can asynchronous type of chat. Through mails we can do the communication. So in today's session we have covered till here. Now exercise part is there. What is chat? Recently we have done. It's a medium to communicate between two or more than two people by using the internet services. Write down the full form of IM. The full form of IM is internet messenger or instant messaging. We can write. Who invented IRC? IRC was invented by Jerko Okerian. So in next session we will meet with the next part. In this part, if you are facing any problem, you can contact me on my personal WhatsApp number. Thank you. Have a nice day for this session. Thank you so much.